Hi, welcome. Today we're going to have the opportunity to look at theories of motivation. We'll have a chance to look at one theory of motivation that you've learned in first year and three new ones. But before we get there, what I'd like to do is have a solid ground in terms of definition of motivation and three factors that affect our motivation we need to consider as managers and future leaders. Let's just make sure we're on the same page with respect to motivation. So what is it? Essentially, we're looking at the reason one has for acting a certain way, or one's directions to behaviors. Generally speaking, there's three variables that affect an employee and how they act within your workplace. So let's first consider the individual. And with that individual, we can look at their needs and drives in terms of what motivates them. Secondly, I'd like to look at the job or work itself that that person is a part of. And lastly, we must consider our actions as a manager, and how our actions influence this whole picture for our given employee. So if we consider these three things when we're looking at being an effective leader or manager, we have a good start. So as we delve deeper into our theories of motivation, you'll recall Daniel Pink's drive from first year. That theory would fit into the individual needs and drive. Hackman and Oldman's job characteristics model, which you're going to see shortly, fits in here with the job and work itself as a variable. When you consider the managerial actions, McGregor's X and Y theory will fit well there. And the last one, the hygiene and motivation factors from Hertzberg, actually touches on each of these. So managers, future leaders, some things to consider when we're looking at motivating our employees in the workplace.